Hello everyone, we are Group 1 and our topic is Frito-Lays by PepsiCo. Frito-Lays is a snack food division of PepsiCo and the largest supplier of potato and corn chips in the world. Currently holding 49% of market share in India and 40% globally and selling its product in 120 countries, Frito-Lays is succeeding against multitude of competitors in fierce yet slow growth industry, selling approximately 4.5 billion packages of snacks per year. In order to achieve this, the company has learned how to masterfully create, innovate, and manage all its aspects of supply chain using high-tech IT systems that allow its greater control over its production, processes, and distribution network. PepsiCo supply chain for manufacturing Frito-Lays potato chips are through contract farming for potatoes in India. India is placed third in the world for the major potato producing countries. It produces around 25 metric tons of potatoes that contribute to approximately 8% of world's total produce. Frito-Lays supply chain is a good example of how international quality requirements are met by the smallest farmers. For the convenience, we have divided our supply chain in three parts that are sourcing, production, and distribution.
This is the overall model of Frito-Lays supply chain for Lays chips manufacturing. It consists of three parts: the upstream, where the sourcing happens, then the manufacturing followed by the downstream, where the distribution channels take the product to the consumers through different modes and retail outlets. In the upstream, the stakeholders are PepsiCo and the farmers. The manufacturing happens at different factories across India. In the downstream, the stakeholders are the distribution partners and the retailers. Source, make and deliver happens at both farmers' production area and also at the PepsiCo's manufacturing units.
Sourcing strategy of the company is decided by top level management using the demand levels that are forecasted. In order to optimize the cost, Frito-Lay purchases their raw materials domestically. The primary raw material being potato are sourced from farmers who enter into contractual agreements with the company. Frito-Lay distributes the seeds to the farmers who have entered into these such agreements and also monitor the growth, the quality as per the standards. The company also provides various assistance to these farmers in terms of teaching them latest agricultural technology, helping farmers avail agricultural loans, etc. Frito-Lay also owns field inspectional centers where the growth of the potatoes are continuously monitored, and also they are maintained in such a way that their demands are continuously met. PepsiCo also runs many more initiatives in the regions in order to achieve long-term sustainability. Although the market prices of the potatoes are widely fluctuating, the fixed rate offered by the company is most advantageous for the farmers. In India, potatoes are cultivated in the states of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Assam, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, and Karnataka. PepsiCo, which is the parent company of Frito-Lay, has established snacks factories strategically in many of these states.
PepsiCo sets up the field offices or the designated stations to collect the potatoes produced by the farmers to test and grade them. If the collected potatoes, the lot fails the standard set by the PepsiCo in terms of dimensions, quality and other parameters, etc., the lot will be rejected and the payment will not be processed further. If the collected potatoes from the farmers match with the standards, then it will be the ownership will be taken by the PepsiCo from the farmers. The payments will be processed for the farmers and the collected potatoes will be taken to the manufacturing units. If the farmers are under some kind of loan, then the PepsiCo wire transfers the money directly to their bank account. The processing of payment to the farmers doesn't take more than 15 days.
Part.
So currently about 26% of Pepsi's export turnovers comes from processed agricultural products, including basmati rice, peanut butter, tomato, chili, garlic and ginger paste. The company has been working with farmers in Punjab since the 1980s, initially pulping tomatoes in return for obtaining government permission to produce and sell its drink in India. Pepsi introduced new varieties that have helped boost the state's tomato crop from 18,000 tons in 1988 to 300,000 tons in recent years. Although no longer involved in tomatoes, PepsiCo had a 5-year program with the Punjab government to provide several hundred farmers with 4 million sweet orange trees for its Tropicana juices by 2008. PepsiCo has 3 potato processing plants in India, located in Punjab, West Bengal, and Ranjangaon near Pune in Maharashtra. The production capacity at these 3 plants is approximately 10,000 tons for Channo in Punjab, 18,000 tons for Pune and 7,500 tons for Kolkata. Potatoes are currently procured from Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal during the winter season and from Karnataka and Maharashtra during the summer months. The quantity of potatoes sourced under contract farming has risen from 2,920 tons in 2002 to 57,000 tons in 2007. Potatoes sourced under contract farming account roughly 55 to 58% of PepsiCo's total requirements. The company is currently working on extending the land area under potato in Jharkhand and Bihar. Now let's talk about the company's sustainable sourcing program. The company holds their suppliers to the same standards of integrity to which the company holds themselves. An unethical or illegal act by a supplier may hurt PepsiCo's reputation as a world-class company and cause a loss of goodwill in the communities they serve. Therefore, all suppliers are expected to follow their supplier code of conduct and relevant policies and commitments as a condition of doing business with the company. These include PepsiCo Global Supplier Code of Conduct, PepsiCo Environmental Health and Safety Policy, PepsiCo Sustainable Agriculture Policy, PepsiCo Land Use Policy, PepsiCo Forestry Stewardship Policy, PepsiCo Sustainable Packaging Policy, and PepsiCo Human Rights Workplace Policy. Suppliers are expected to take action to correct any non-compliances identified through the on-site audits, with a focus on continuous improvement throughout their operations. In 2016, 794 on-site audits were conducted or recognized with first-tier suppliers using the SMETA 4-pillar audit protocol or an equivalent assessment. Following the on-site audits, sites were scored based on any non-compliance reported by the auditor, with sites scored from red to green based on the severity and the number of instances of non-compliance found on-site.
We would now be talking about the production process of Lay's chips. The raw materials used for these are potatoes, fine vegetable oil, salt, spices and other additives which add to the masalas, and finally the packaging material used for the packaging of the chips. Upon arrival of the potatoes, the lot is unloaded and washed thoroughly and passed through jets of water to eliminate any chances of dirt whatsoever. Then comes the peeling part, which consists of a machine equipped with highly delicate round peeling blades to make the process faster. The peeling is followed by halving and manual inspection by 4 experts who analyze and trim each potato, eliminating the unfit potatoes from the belt. Then comes the fine slicing and second wash process to prepare the chips for frying and seasoning. The chips are passed through a massive frying machine which consists of a fine quality vegetable oil. PepsiCo maintains the order of quality by sourcing the vegetable oil from the same vendor upon thorough analysis and quality inspection.
So prior to going through the product line, there's a material inspection process where potatoes go to the cutting section workers to check any defective ones are there. The potato use should be higher content of starch. The workers need to have a fitness certificate saying that they are healthy and they wash their hands before working. Production monitoring involves all the activities which minimizes the spoilage of the production factors, as Lay's is intending to make the whole production cycle a sustainable process. After it's passed the material inspection and the initial process, each fried chip too is taken through a machine called optical sorting machine, which is built with highly optical cameras, scanning hundreds of chips a minute, eliminating burnt out or unfit chips for further process. So what do they do with the eliminated chips? Well, the eliminated chips are crushed, fined and then taken to the plant's biodegradable zone, for 100% utility of the products put into process. The approved chips are shuffled through seasoning loops, which process one flavor of Lays at a time. The seasoning consists of the basic masalas and some secret ingredients, which makes Lays stand out in the market. After this also, they have take some samples for checking the quality and the taste. And this concludes the production of Lays, with the seasoned chips transferred up to the packaging and section division room. The storing, production and packaging rooms are kept separate, keeping in mind the necessary temperature and moisture control each one of these sectors require for healthy production of chips.
We will now move on to the conventional packaging of Lays packets. The conventional packaging for potato chips is typically made up at least four different layers, and each has a very, very specific purpose. The innermost layer is almost always a polymer called BOPP, which stands for biaxially oriented polypropylene. It is the gold standard today in terms of food safe materials that protect package contents. BOPP is a great barrier for moisture, oils, gases that contaminate the chips with bad odors and taste. BOPP is almost used as a middle layer after second layer of LDPE, low density polyethylene. LDPE provides potato chips packaging with strength and additional grease resistance. Finally, the outermost layer is usually a thermoplastic resin whose trademark name is Serlin. Manufacturers love Serlin because it adds strength and puncture resistance to the chip bag and can heat seal shut very quickly at a very low temperature. Some brands are trying to shake up these conventions in the interest of making a more conventionally environmentally friendly option, primarily PLA, polylactic acid. You may have experienced this firsthand when buying a healthy chip alternative or potato chips from brands that market themselves as organic. You would know something was different about that packaging almost immediately. Although the material is biodegradable, it is much noisier than conventional chip packaging when being handled and opened.
To talk about the distribution practices of the Frito-Lay, the main hub or the factory where production of Frito-Lay happens is situated in the Pune region of India. The distribution hierarchy followed by Frito-Lay starts from the company factory, which is followed by the clearing and forwarding agent from where it is sent to all the distributors and sub-stockists. The monthly payment is done by CNF to the company and further products are sent to the retailers, which act as a point of contact for the customers to buy product. Majorly, three types of distributors are present: wholesale distributor, traditional distributor and sub-stockist. Wholesale distributor look after to the wholesale market. The traditional distributors look after to the retail market. And super stockists are those distributors which supply products to the retail outlets and to sub-distributors. The sub-distributors cannot order or get the delivery from the CNF. Majorly, two practices are followed by the Frito-Lay for delivery, which is ready stock and pre-sales. In case of ready stocks, the stocks which are delivered without any prior information or booking from the retail outlets. In such cases, the vehicle is stuffed with as much products as possible, and thus products are supplied to these retail outlets on the ready basis. They are majorly aimed at covering 25 outlets per day, which is irrespective of the sales volume. Whereas in case of pre-sales, the prior orders are taken. To talk about certain strategies followed by the Frito-Lay are: every outlet is important, push and pull strategy, care, clear visibility of the product, clear understanding of the customers and covering more outlets than sales volume, and replacement of damaged products. They also provide additional services to the retailers in the form of racks and hangers. However, most of the retailers prefer to keep the anti-rodent racks. The anti-rodent racks are however not available in the market, and so Frito-Lays can provide anti-rodent racks and gain a consideration by the company to provide a safer storage for the products. Further findings suggest that the delivery to a particular market is not fixed by the agents or the sub-stockist in RRSA, so they ask for the credit facility, which is not given by the sub-stockist, and hence reduction in the sales happens. So we can try and fix a time by the agent. Thank you.
Let's see the SWOT analysis of Lays distribution channel. First, let's talk about strengths. Lays enjoys a strong brand image and reputation in the snacks market. Lays products have good demand in the local markets, including rural markets. It has a variety of product lines from chips as well as snacks. Lays drives on PepsiCo's distribution system, which is one of the strongest in the world, and allows Lays to be available and accessible to a large customer base. Coming to its weaknesses, team has lack of information about the local customer's taste preferences in the Indian rural market, inability to deliver the products in proper quantity and time to meet the demand in the local market. Also, no credit policies have been set in place for the retailers. Talking about opportunities, Lays can set up distribution channels in the rural markets with proper focus on big retailers as well as retailers selling high quantities of other brands. Lays can set up some potential sub-stockists in rural market, having good holdover outlets of those areas, thus increasing sales and market share. Finally, to list some of the threats, many big brands like ITC, Perfetti are offering numerous schemes and policies for the retailers and distributors, thus causing threat to Lay's market share. Many local brands like Zing, Kurkure, etc. are providing greater profit margin to the retailers and distributors and also with credit facilities in some cases, hence reducing the market share of the Frito-Lays. It has been seen that there are a lot of issues relating to the distribution channels. Taking into account those issues, I would like to make a few recommendations which could probably benefit the company as well as its distribution channels. Most of the retailers argue that the margins of the other brands, especially local ones, are better than those provided by Lays. So, I recommend the company to think about the matter and come up with some good margin which will attract the retailers very much. Recently, in many places, it has been found that the Lays packets get air leaked. So, I want to recommend the company to look after such problems. The retailers want attractive racks in their outlets, so the company should arrange to deliver more new racks with attractive colors. Also, some retailers prefer anti-rodent racks to prevent loss due to rodents, so company should consider attractive as well as anti-rodent racks which ensures the retailers of safe storage. The company, in order to improve its efficiency in the distribution process, should look upon timely delivery of products to the retailers, ensure that the schemes are properly conveyed to the retailers, and also, if possible, look after their profit margins.